Man, it's good to actually hang out with you guys again. I feel like it's been forever since we've been able to just chill, you know?
Bro, you see me at least once a week. What are you talking about?
I'm talking about Miss Freaking Flyer Miles.
Paid off too. Things are looking pretty good. Should have at least a couple of first round picks signed with me in the next few weeks.
Ooh, get it, Jay!
Well, I owe you big time. If you didn't give me a shot, who knows where I would be.
You would be in the exact same position. You would have figured it out.
Since we're sharing big news, I got some myself. I mean, paperwork ain't signed yet, but looks like I'm gonna be doing some exclusive work with Nike, advising their newest signings on their brand direction.
Zoe?
So? 100%. They saw that I was the brains behind your operation. They just had to have me.
It's Madden NFL 22 on EA Sports. And the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the Jaguars and the Jets coming up next.
Take the Lincoln Tunnel through Weehawken, through Secaucus, across the Hackensack. Life Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Jets ball club. They come in losers of two straight, so they're trying to right the ship here a little bit.
They're teetering a little bit, aren't they? And now things could really go south if they lose this game, so they understand the importance of playing well and stopping this streak.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Jaguars, it's late in the year. We all know it. We've seen the calendar for these guys. Their bodies could probably use a break, but they have to push on.
And they're really not as worried about that as maybe we think. They know they've got the entire offseason to rest. All they care about is the game.
This is James Robinson, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The numbers in last week's ball game for Robinson. 12 carries, 84 yards.
Well, he's the number two runner in the league, and you just know the offensive line wants to get him to number one because most of the good ball carriers, they take care of their linemen. Could be a gold watch in their future if he becomes a leading rusher.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
On first down, it's Robinson. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn them into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. What a surprise here on third and one. They'll run it now with Robinson. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. A lot of running backs, a little bit of a disadvantage when you start talking MVP. Might not be the case this year. You think he's got a shot, don't you?
I do. I think he's got more than a shot. But what he's going to need here down the stretch.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Travis Etienne, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Jags have taken the early lead. Just power football there down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in, have to report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal.
Begin the drive with Robinson. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The Jags with a football to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a first and 10. They'll run here with Robinson. And he'll manage to pick up about four in second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back there. They'll feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Jaguars. Marvin Jones hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead.
We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it,
they'll start on the ground, ETN.
And some room to maneuver. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
And that's a pleasing run there by Travis Etienne. And every time I see him carry it, I think of the word mature. Why? 4 full seasons at Clemson, not something you normally get with a running back. Had almost 5,000 yards rushing, the school record, along with 70 rushing.
Oh, that's just not fair. And now room to run. Touchdown, Jaguars! DJ Chark becoming just the second player with 30 touchdowns in a single year.
And the Jaguars are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we could at least put this one in our top 5. That was a determined gallop there.
Yeah, this is a guy who runs with such balance and control. I mean, he went through that early contact just like he was driving him.
Brady now on first down. He's got a man wide open. It's Landry. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. Now Brady. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that is caught. And he has now tied the record. Touchdown.
I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass his young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed. aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. He's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time through the air. 33 yards.
Already over 1,000 yards receiving this season. That catch is just going to add to his total. Certainly not resting on his laurels. He's trying to continue to gain as many yards as possible and continue this big season.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. To throw is Brady. That's pulled in, the veteran Carter Landry. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. This is caught. Touchdown! Carter Landry, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars are able to add on to their first half lead.
If you did know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, he can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of...
Now after the fumble recovery, it's Brady. He's going to let this one go deep. Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Travis Etienne as the first half is winding down. And the Jaguars will extend their lead here just before halftime.
Well, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but his top two options were not available on that throw, so he went the safe route, worked out pretty well.
It was like you were in the pocket. How about you?
They start on the ground with Robinson here. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Again, it's Robinson. Powers through him. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And Shark calls it in. And he is into the end zone, and the touchdown record is now all his.
Well, we know that he can beat you in a number of ways. He can catch it short, he can take it long, or he can do what we just saw right there, catch it, and then run with a football.
And plenty to praise on the play, but this is also a bit of a breakdown defensively because you've got to be right on him when he makes the catch. Otherwise, he has the ability to really make you pick it up. Excellent.
Now ETN to start the drive. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
He's going to try and do this himself.
One more, one more.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there and worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
On first down, Brady. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Jaguars. Sometimes you just got to marvel at how these guys can throw the football. He gave that everything he had, and it was right on the money.
And we often talk about hang time for punts, but in this case, we should probably calculate the hang time on that throw because that one hung up there for a long time and managed to keep going and target.
Now a handoff to start it out. Robinson. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. To throw, it's Brady. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. 4-1 show Fatakasi with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came. They covered.
On first and 10, here's Brady. He stiff arms him. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big connection on that one. 34 yards.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
Oh, good. Fighting through, and he's got space. Touchdown, Jaguars. Travis Etienne with his third touchdown so far, number 13 now on the year. And the Jaguars get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe. One continue. They'll run on first down. Robinson brings it just past the 15, able to avoid the initial contact, but not much more there on the play. 51 yards on the ground for him so far. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Now he'll try to run with this. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold.
Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Touchdown, Jaguars. Touchdown. DJ Chark, 85 yards. And the Jaguars extend their fourth quarter lead, and they are closing in now on a 14-win campaign. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He playing like...
Watch one, watch one.
On first down, it's Robinson.
Here we go.
So fourth quarter, a nice run there to start this drive. Charles, what do you think the split will be here between run and pass?
Well, partner, I think it'll lean towards the run, but this is also not a time where you just totally do that. You still have to possess the ball, move the sticks, and keep the clock moving as well. So they'll run their offense, but yeah, when they have a chance to run it, they'll do that a little bit more.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
The Jaguars on third down. They've been good, 3-for-4 thus far. This will be third and six. Looking downfield for Jones. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Marvin Jones, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Jaguars continue to roll.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is when the pressure... He just...
Sack! Viking 18! Mike. Hey. Let's go. Here we got Mike.
They'll run on first down. Robinson uses the stiff arm.
Had a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Second down at seven.
They'll run again here with Robinson, and he'll get this up to about the 40. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And some room to roam now. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. So another score there, and often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep. On first down, Robinson. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line.
148 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. On the run, it's Robinson. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. They run, Robinson.
And this will be a Jaguars first down as he'll take this up to about the 33-yard line. It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So So for the Jaguars, it's another win for them, and you wonder if they want a redo on that one loss as they sit now at 14-1. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to New England to take on the Patriots.